And they weren't born yet. So I love this. Now, when you have a burgeoning stash and a deep stash like this, there has to be a way to make it work, to make it do what you want to do. And there's a few things that I think about fabric that if we be a little bit analytical, you might just agree with me. So we're gonna have some fun string piecing with our neutral strips, working with half square triangles, and specialty rulers, and since we're in a nice enclosed room and the doors are shut, if this is a pinky square just for Florida and what's said in Quilt Guild never leaves Quilt Guild.
Strips about a quarter of an inch all the way around. I want to go just a bit bigger than my paper, because what if I miss, and what if one of my strips ends up right here close to the corner, and I really don't want to sew another piece that close to the corner because it'll become really bulky. If I have overpieced on this other side, I can shift the ruler when I trip. So leaving yourself a little bit of margin around your square is gonna allow you to make up for some mistakes that will happen, because we're working from different widths of strips. And what I like to tell people is that your ugliest block will happen first and you'll learn from there, okay? About that we get from working with paper that we don't get when you're working from muslin or dryer sheets or leave-in foundation or interfacing or whatever that is. Because we are piecing on the diagonal, if you're working with a fabric foundation, it has bias. Even if it's a cut square, you're working corner to corner. Mm-hmm. And you've got straight strips going on a bias. And so that bias sometimes does this down the square. And then you go to press your strip over, and your block can be kind of twisted or warpy. Sometimes, like I said, that things shift, and you might look at your block and one of these strips has a little bit of fullness in it. Well, let's just say that this one was just a little bit puffy and it's not gonna lay flat. Because it's paper, you just tug to release your stitches, then press it nice with the iron. The paper's done its job, and I think one thing that I forgot to
yeah.
You're gonna have to pick them up.
Yeah, position them.
But we're gonna send them through colored end first.
Okay, that was it. Okay.
Yeah.
There, okay, yeah, so you can go through here from one to one to one.
Also, when because you're sewing a little bit scant, if there's a little tiny V in the top of your unit, don't worry about it. It's like missing the corner on your paper foundation. It'll be within your seam allowance. Okay. What matters is that those units measure 2.5 by 2.5.
They're coming out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What were you saying about a little tiny V?
Like this, so that when blocks join each other, those will automatically nest. So you just, oh, see now this one's going to go the opposite direction. Can you see this? Uh-huh. So when you pick up block quarters for these broken dishes units, make sure you lay them all out identical and that you always pick up the pieces in the same order so that they will only spin one direction.
They had so much luggage. You found yourself out a big, lightweight